Hey guys, how's everybody doing today? Well, let's continue with the jobs. This is number four, I believe. Sorry it's been so long, but just, you know, we're getting towards the end of the school year here and, you know, things pile up and you get busy. Anyway, so I believe I left you last time I was working at the magnet warehouse. Man, that job. Anyway, so after I quit there, I was out of work for a little while and then I started looking around. I still didn't feel like teaching. So I was looking in the paper, I believe, and found something interesting. It's a service called Dico. And what that is, it's like a taxi service. You partner up with somebody and you've got a company car. The two of you are sitting in the car waiting. You got the CB radio in the car, and what it is the drunk people will call the company and order a car, and we drive out to wherever, whichever bar they're at, pick them up, and I would drive my company car, and my partner would take the customer's car, and we drive them home. So it's, you know, basically just a way for drunk people to get their car home. And get home in one piece. So I did that for about, oh, I was more than a year easily. Now, out of all the jobs that I've had here in Japan, that one was probably the most fun. I don't remember ever not wanting to go to work, except for like maybe on really rainy days or something, because a lot of times we would have, you know, downtime. What we would do is we had like, I don't know, 5 or 6 cars going at one time, and we would line up outside the station. That was our waiting area, and when you'd get a call, you'd just go, and you'd go pick up the customer and take them wherever they need to go, and then you'd go back to the station and you'd wait there for the next call. Occasionally, if we were really busy, you'd be out on a run, and when you radioed in that you were finished with that run, they would send you somewhere else. Now, they were they were pretty good at not running you all over the place to get to different bars. If you were in a certain area, they would try to. And, you know, and calls were coming in, they would try to get you to, you know, stay basically in that area. So that way, you know, cut down on, you know, gas and stuff like that. But yeah, that job was really fun. I really enjoyed that. Now that was a night job, obviously. So I started at 7 p.m. and then I finished at 2 a.m. And there were some times a customer would call at like 1:55. Now, when you're getting ready to finish work, you don't like somebody calling in and, you know, having you do more work. And you would always pray that if somebody called in at the last minute, that they weren't going very far. But we had this one customer. It wasn't all the time, but he did it enough that we knew who he was. And we knew which bar that he drank at, and if we got the call at 1:55 to go to the certain bar, we knew exactly who it was. So this guy, we would pick him up in the city called Shimada, which we were going from Fujieda, which is probably a good 20-minute drive just to get down to the bar. And then he was going down to a city called Iwate, which is down near Hamamatsu, which is a good hour and a half away. So we'd get the call at like 1:55, just before 2 o'clock. And then we'd get down there by, you know, 2:15, 2:20, 2:30, whatever. And then we have to drive him down there. We'd get down there, you know, 3:30, 4 o'clock in the morning. And then we have to drive back, and, you know, we wouldn't get in till, you know, 5 in the morning. So that kind of sucked. But at the same time, if you were partnered up with somebody that you got along with, it was enjoyable because, you know, you guys could, you know, just, you know, shoot the bull while you're working and stuff like that. That job was really, really fun. And I would recommend that for anybody that has, you know, like I said, my visa situation, I was on a spouse visa at the time, so I didn't need anybody to sponsor a visa for me. I could work wherever I wanted to work. I didn't have to be in the English field or anything like that. So if you're in that situation, DICO was a pretty good job. But since the time that I did that, the law has changed a little bit, and you have to have a certain type of driver's license for it, and it, you know, probably similar to what a taxi driver has. At that time, it didn't matter. As long as you just had a driver's license, that was good enough. So, you know, you get the downside would be those late calls that have you out till 5 in the morning. Rainy days really, really sucked because you're just stuck sitting in the car. On nice evenings, you could, you know, sometimes we would go to work. We'd sit in the office until the first call comes. And occasionally, you clock in at 7, and you may not get your first call till 9 o'clock. You know, it's a really slow night. You go out and do that one run, and then you go back to the station, and then you sit there till 2 in the morning, and all you've done is, you know, one run, maybe two. Then there were other times, you know, certain times of the year, especially towards the end of the year when they're doing the year-end parties, which are called Bonenkai. And especially like on Fridays and Saturdays on Bonenkai season, I mean, you could, you know, rack up 10, 12, 15 runs, and that's a lot. If they were near, you could rack up a lot of them. I don't think I had any scary situations. There was one night we went and picked these guys up, and they were in the parking lot. I was sitting in the company car. I never usually got out and interacted with the customer. But I was sitting in the car, and this group of guys came out. I think 4 or 5 of them. And they seemed kind of rough type. And they were being, you know, a little rough and grumble with my partner. They weren't, you know, they weren't bullying him or anything, but, you know, they weren't being really, really polite. And then one of them came over to the car, and they saw me, and I got out of the car, and they were like, "Oh," because, you know, I'm a big guy, you know, I was a lot bigger than all of them. But then they were also surprised, you know, seeing a foreigner doing this. So the mood instantly turned to something interesting for them, and they really enjoyed, you know, asking about me and stuff like that. So that went really smooth. Now, like I said, I wouldn't interact with the customers as far as the getting in their cars, but when they came to pay, I was the one they paid. And at first, there was, you know, the surprise to see the foreigner doing this. But then, you know, as the time went on, you know, you get regular customers, and, you know, they got used to me, and, you know, never really had a problem with anybody. I've only driven a customer's car twice, and both of them were really nice cars. The first one was a Ferrari. I drove a Ferrari. We had a customer, he was a dentist, and he had 3 or 4 really nice sports cars, and I had commented, he had this white Ferrari, and I had commented to him one night that I'd never driven a Ferrari, it looks really cool, blah blah blah. I don't know what it is, we got all these military trucks over on the other side. Anyway, so one night he came out of the bar, and he had the Ferrari, and my partner went to get in. He said no, and he motioned for me. So I went over and, you know, plopped my ass in the Ferrari and drove him home. And there's this one street that we had to take. It's a really long, straight street. And, you know, it's, you know, after midnight, there aren't any cars on the road. And, you know, I'm following the laws of the rules of the road as I'm supposed to. And he just told me, he said, "Open it up." You know, he says, go ahead, you know, put your foot down. So, you know, I, you know, laid into it and hauled ass up that street. You know, that's all it was. You know, just got to drive a Ferrari. Now, my impression of a Ferrari, after driving one, I kind of lost interest in them. They're not as not as comfortable as I imagine them to be, and they're I don't know. I guess I'm just not a sports car type person. Now the other car that I drove was a what the hell's the name of the Nissan? Was it Nissan? Shit, I can't think of the name of it. It was really popular sports car at the time. Sorry guys, I can't remember the name of it. If I do, I'll throw it in another video sometime. But anyway, yeah, that was a good job. All right, guys. Oh, geez, we're over 10 minutes. Okay, so I will leave that at that. And the next video, we go into the world of billiards. All right, guys, everybody have a great day. I hope you enjoyed this. As usual, if you have any questions, make sure you leave them down below. Tell your friends, share the video, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button and hang around. And we'll leave you at that. All right, guys, have a great week, and don't let your meatloaf.